again. What's going on, everybody? It's The Bull Show, aka Aiden, and welcome back to another video. Today, I've got a video in relation to an award that our coach Billy Donovan has won. And in the end, it's a very interesting award. And just as this time has come, it's a perfect time to discuss Billy Donovan's coaching, whether it's been good enough, whether it's been whether there needs to be room for improvement, all of that situation. And of course, as someone that does watch every single Bulls game, and I know many of you guys watch every single Bulls game as well, there are things that you do begin to pick up about Billy Donovan that I think are very good, and some things that I just, for the life of me, can't understand why he does. But again, I think it's a very well-deserved award, obviously just based on our record and what happened from last year to this year. We're going to be talking all about it in this video. Before we get started, please like and subscribe to The Bull Show, turn notifications on, and let me know in the comments below your thoughts about Billy Donovan, his Coach of the Month award, which is the award that he won, and obviously, are you satisfied with his coaching decisions so far? So, let's talk about the positives and the negatives about Billy Donovan so far, ladies and gentlemen, this year. I think Billy Donovan has put into effect a very unique way of playing. And again, all of that does come down to the coaching staff, the style of play. At the end of the day, the coaches set out the way that we expect to play, and the players are expected to deliver on the court from what the coach is asking of them. So the small ball, run out in transition, try to focus more on ball movement is something that I think Billy Donovan has put into effect, and I think the Bulls have responded fairly well to it. Obviously, it's been inconsistent at times, but I really think the style of play that Billy Donovan wants to use is something that I think is very suitable for the way the Chicago Bulls, the players that we have, and the way that we operate. Obviously, having someone like Lonzo Ball, Alex Caruso, and then you have other players that can pass the ball like Vucevic, LaVine, DeRozan, that's a style of play that focuses more on ball movement, playmaking, trying to get the highest assist numbers that you can. And I think in recent times, we have seen what ball movement can do for the Chicago Bulls. And I think Billy Donovan plays a big part in how we play and that movement that we use and also the style of play that we have. So there's a very big positive there. I also think that he does have a very good sense of when to call timeouts, when to try to make sure that the momentum for the other team is not sustained. And I think he does a fantastic job in that area as well. Obviously, these are just minor things for the Chicago Bulls that definitely go a long way. For example, he likes to call timeouts very, very early throughout the first quarter. And the reason is there has been some times where the Bulls do not perform well in the first quarter. You get the sense and the feeling behind what the Chicago Bulls are doing, how they're playing, how they even come out in the second half like the New York Knicks. He called a timeout so early against the New York Knicks in the last game because the Bulls came out so lazy and the New York Knicks came out and full court pressed us. So at the end of the day, that's something that Billy Donovan noticed and took a quick timeout very, very early in this third quarter to try and adjust. Obviously, the adjustment didn't work well, but nevertheless, it's an adjustment that needed to be made. And also, throughout the course of the beginning of the season, the first quarter timeouts, in my opinion, was exactly what we needed as well. When we started off poorly, you bring a timeout in very quickly to try and get the team energized again, because at the end of the day, you never want bad starts to an NBA game. He has a very good sense of when to time out for the Chicago Bulls. He's a very good sense of when to stop momentum for the other team. What I also like about Billy Donovan is that he's very adaptable. At the end of the day, the reason why he won Coach of the Month for the Chicago Bulls, and again, it's a very good accomplishment to have, one very few that Bulls coaches do have. We haven't seen it in a while. We haven't seen it under Jim Boylan. We didn't see it under Fred Hoiberg or any of that. So it has been a while. So for me personally, the reason why he won Coach of the Month is because his ability to adapt and his ability to kind of make things sustainable with a new team. At the end of the day, we can't hide the accolades or I guess the accomplishment that he's made here. Only two players so far in this team that have played consistently in Zach LaVine and Kobe White to an extent is still remaining on this team. Of course, Vucevic as well, technically from the trade deadline. So a couple of players there, but most of this team is brand new. Had to adjust to each other, work with each other, play with each other, train with each other every single day to try and get better. And the fact that we had the start that we did to the season in October, and the fact that we still have in late November, early December now, the record that we have is, in my opinion, it's a phenomenal reach for the Chicago Bulls, considering where we ended up being from the beginning with only three players that were actually on this team last year. That's incredible. That's something that I'm very, very happy about. And it's something that I did say a few months ago about Billy Donovan, is that we've seen every single team, every single year is a new team for him. He's not had a sustainable ride with the same team 3, 4, 5 years. It's not been like that for Billy Donovan at all. He's always had to mix and change systems. He's always had to adapt to the star players coming in and star players leaving. And this is just another example of him being successful at that. The beginning of the season last year, we had Zach LaVine, Kobe White, Wendell Carter, Larry Markkanen, Otto Porter, Patrick Williams. Those were the main guys around the team at the beginning. And then this year, we've got Lonzo Ball, DeMar DeRozan, Zach LaVine, Nikola Vucevic, Javonte Green, and then you got Alex Caruso and players of that sort off the bench. Completely different team, and yet we are sustaining, we are surviving, and not only that, I think we're thriving right now with the Chicago Bulls. So that is obviously a big reason, in my opinion, why he won that Coach of the Month award. Looking at the negatives for Billy Donovan, because there are a few that I have picked up in terms of his, his style. Because he's very persistent, and I think he's a bit stubborn in the way that he wants to play. He always persists on going small ball when I don't think it's not always right to go small ball. And it hasn't cost us too much. Obviously, we could have a lot better of a record than what we have now, but our record is still fairly great for a team that is still brand new to each other. So I'm not really too bothered about the record, but there have been some times where the team plays so big, like Portland, for example, and then even the Knicks in the last game where we did win, and the Knicks in the game before where we did win, where they played so big and we played so small that it clearly sees a big mismatch there. And I don't think the Chicago Bulls were good in any stretch of the means in trying to rectify those mismatches. So therefore, playing small, in my opinion, is sometimes very frustrating to watch. And for the life of me, I sit and watch those games and I just think to myself, why can't we play Alize Johnson? I'm not even saying a power forward, just play him in general, because he's someone that can get some rebounds and maybe guard a player like Julius Randle. He has a little bit more height on him. Maybe he can do something in that area. Or maybe even Tony Bradley. We haven't seen him for a while. I feel like the rotations are set, but also the rotations are too set. He doesn't switch up the rotation anywhere near as much as a coach does. And Tom Thibodeau is someone that fixes the rotation up, switches it up. I can't remember the last time I saw Kevin Knox with the New York Knicks, but he played today and he did okay. He made a shot, and I think that's all he did. For the Bulls, I kind of know exactly who's going to come on at the exact time, and the rotation is set, and there's nothing else to really spark that rotation or switch it up. There's nothing that we see that could potentially be valuable from a player that we don't normally use, like a Tony Bradley or an Alize Johnson. I think the fans can probably see things, but the coaching staff don't want to go down that route. They want a set rotation, and they want the set minutes and all of that. And I think, in terms of the NBA season, you have to become a little bit more creative. Otherwise, you get too predictable. So I do want to see a little bit of a switch up in the rotation here and there. Not just because of injuries, but because we see something that we can exploit in other teams. I think that's a very good area to go down. And I think we have to try and keep on doing that in terms of the Chicago Bulls, so we just don't become too stagnant and too predictable. I think by now, most of these players know how to play with each other, so it's not even an issue of chemistry anymore. I just think it's time to just switch it up and see what we can get out of some of those players. That's probably the biggest negative in terms of Billy Donovan, not switching it up at times when I feel like we need it. But ladies and gentlemen, I think that's the only negative I could truly say with a big heart is a big problem. Because outside of that, there are just small details in terms of Billy Donovan that I think that we can see rectified over time. For example, isolation, I think, is something that we are slowly starting to get away from. Obviously, there are some games where we're going to need it, but most games we need ball movement. And I think Billy Donovan is focusing a lot more on ball movement as of now. I also think that he's trying very hard to utilize his players to the best of his ability. One of the positives about him as well is that he is adaptable, and the stars that he gets in, he uses their strengths to the best of his ability. So DeMar DeRozan is having a great season. Zach LaVine is having a great season. Vucevic is having a good stretch of games. Lonzo Ball is someone that we can utilize more, but obviously that's something that I believe will come in time. So those are a few negatives, that maybe we don't utilize everybody to their best, but the star players are being utilized to their best right now, which is the best part of the Chicago Bulls and the reason why we're winning so much. And the negative is just not switching it up enough. And I think we do need to have a little bit of, a pick and choose kind of situation. How do you get a team, for example, we've versus the Brooklyn Nets in a couple of games. How do you get Brooklyn Nets off of their game plan? How do you throw them off? You could potentially throw them off by switching up the rotation, maybe switching up some minutes, things like that. And I think that could be very valuable. But that's nitpicking, ladies and gentlemen. I think Billy Donovan rightfully deserves the Coach of the Month award. I think with the record that he has, with the brand new team that he has, he's only had a terrific start. And I think things are going to go up from here. I heard something of that note that he hasn't trained with this team since the Los Angeles Lakers game. So that's 2 weeks that he hasn't properly trained with the team because our schedule was so jam-packed. And he's had a chance to kind of train with them now. So again, it just shows how fulfilling and how long the NBA season is and how quickly those games come. But also, it shows that these players don't often train as much as they should. So you don't get better at the game plans that you want. So I say, be very, very patient with Billy Donovan. Be very, very patient with this team. And I think you'll see the best out of this team come mid-season, come towards the end of the season. I think you'll see a much better Chicago Bulls than what you see now, hopefully, if everybody is healthy. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe if you're new. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, ladies and gentlemen. Hopefully you've enjoyed Billy Donovan's coaching. I know there are positives and negatives to it. Let me know in the comments below what you think about Billy Donovan. But I think if you just look at the grand scheme of things, he's had a fairly successful month in the month of November and the month of October as well. And I think he rightfully deserves that award. Take care and peace.